In this video, you will learn the performance differences between the latest NVIDIA RTX 3060, 3070, and RTX 3080 laptop GPUs. Stay tuned if you want to know which of these three cards will provide the best value for your hard-earned cash. You need to know that not all graphics cards are created equally, even if they bear the same naming. A 3080 design for laptops will not give you the same performance level as a desktop 3080, and likewise, a 3070 with a power limit of 80 watts will likely be outperformed by a RTX 3060 with 115 watts power limit. Things like power limits, chassis and cooling design all determines how much performance you are able to get from your system. So when you purchase a new laptop, you need to carefully study the power limit of each model and understand that not all laptops are created equally. A 3060 on one laptop can be very different to another 3060 on a different laptop, even though both are called 3060. It is all marketing scheme, but if you understand what you are purchasing and checking out reviews and comparisons on this channel, you are less likely to regret buying into a wrong system. To minimize possible factors such as chassis design, memory configurations, and CPU platform, I have tested three similar laptops from the same manufacturer. All three laptops have the same form factor. All are 17-inch laptops from Asus's ROG Strix series, which share the same type of cooling system, number of heat pipes, and motherboard design. All three laptops use the same type of DDR4 memories, 32GB in dual-channel configuration for equal conditions. The tested GPUs are all power limited to 115 watts, with an additional 15 watts available thanks to Dynamic Boost technology. If you like this video, remember to give me a like and subscribe to the channel. Let me know in the comments what other comparisons you would like to see in the future. I tested several different games with the latest available NVIDIA drivers. The games I have selected vary from graphics-bound titles such as Assassin's Creed Odyssey and Tomb Raider, but also more CPU-bound titles such as Far Cry 5. Testing a big number of games will reveal how good the GPU handles different kinds of games for a more realistic scenario. All three laptops have a turbo mode, and I have tested all games with the laptop's turbo mode enabled. All tests was done at 1080p and with VSync turned off. Assassin's Creed Odyssey is an action RPG. This game is quite demanding on the hardware, and it is also a great game to benchmark as it typically shows a linear gain between each GPU tier. Measuring the game's average FPS, the 3070 was 14% faster than the just-released 3060, while RTX 3080 came out on top, with 77 frames per second versus 72 for the RTX 3070. That's a 7% difference between the two top-tier cards from NVIDIA. In Batman Arkham Knight, the RTX 3070 showed a clear advantage over the 3060, and 3080 was unsurprisingly better than the RTX 3070, although not by as much. Nevertheless, this is a great action-adventure game that looks fantastic no matter what hardware you are playing on, and my favorite game from the Batman series. Let me know what games you are currently playing. And comment below, what is your favorite game of all time? Deus Ex: Mankind Divided is another action RPG that is heavy on the graphics. In the game's built-in benchmark, RTX 3070 scored around 10% faster compared to the 3060, and 3080 returned the highest result I've ever seen with this game, 110 frames per second. A nice 13% boost over the 3070. F1 2018 is a fabulous racing game. The game is very well optimized and usually returns a high FPS. Setting the game's quality settings to the highest, I saw an average FPS of 134 with the RTX 3060. RTX 3070 increased this to 147. Surprisingly, the RTX 3080 only scored 144 frames per second. I retested this over multiple runs, and each time it yielded the same results. In any case, if you are playing on a 144Hz panel, this result is good enough to match the screen's refresh rate. Far Cry 5 is another CPU-bound game. While the results from the RTX 3060 is pretty impressive, going from the 3060 to the 3070 only saw a 2% gain in average FPS, and even if you are maxing out with the RTX 3080, you will only gain 6 more frames in average with the best card from this generation. In other words, if you love Far Cry 5 or other CPU-heavy games, you are likely to see more gain by investing in a faster processor. Next, we are going to see something completely different. Shadow of the Tomb Raider is an action-adventure game that can really take advantage of a high-end GPU. RTX 3070 scored 108 frames per second, which is 10% faster compared to the RTX 3060. If you have the RTX 3080, you can expect another 7% gain over the RTX 3070. This is all tested in ultra settings at 1080p. If you drop the quality settings to high or medium, the game will still run very smoothly at 1440p. Total War: Three Kingdoms was tested with the game's built-in benchmark. At 1080p ultra settings, the RTX 3070 was around 14% faster than a RTX 3060, and RTX 3080 is just 6% faster than a 3070. Real-time strategy games such as the Total War series do not require extremely high FPS to run smoothly. However, if you choose to play at higher resolution, such as 1440p or even 4K, which is really beneficial as you will be seeing more of the map, then the extra power that comes with these new high-end Nvidia cards will certainly come in handy. Fortnite is a popular first-person shooter, to say the least. The game just looks gorgeous, no matter what hardware you choose to run it with. In 1080p in epic settings, you are easily able to hit over 100 frames per second with any of these cards. This is tested with DirectX 11 and Nvidia DLSS turned on. With DLSS on, you are able to gain even higher results. This chart summarizes my findings of the new 3000 series GPUs from Nvidia. Across all games and in average, the 3070 was around 11% faster than the 3060, while RTX 3080 was just 6% ahead of the 3070. It ultimately leads to the question, is it worth it to shell out several hundred of dollars more for an RTX 3080, and is it worth it to buy the 3070 over the 3060? I think there is no right or wrong answer, as people have different needs and budgets. However, purely from a cost versus performance point of view, there is little sense to buy the latest RTX 3080 over the next best thing. How about the RTX 3060 versus RTX 3070? The 70 clearly outperforms the 60 option, and it will also cost more money. Pricing will vary from country to country, and sales promotions might affect your purchase decision. But looking at today's prices of similar laptops, RTX 3070 currently costs around 22% more money compared to the same laptop with the RTX 3060. Considering that the price increase is more than the equivalent performance gain, the wiser choice would be to invest in the 3060 system if you are buying a brand new gaming laptop. Check the links in the video descriptions for the best RTX 3000 series laptops available. If you are interested to see comparisons with the previous generation of Nvidia GPUs, click the card above now. I hope you enjoyed this video, as it took me a lot of resource and time to produce. If you liked what you've learned through this video, a sub to the channel would be massively appreciated. Please take a second to like the video and comment below if you think this video helped you in any way. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.